you were saying when you're looking forward to the matchup, the possible matchup with Bethlehem.
Yeah, possibly. We like that matchup. They had a great win against us during the season. But, you know, these kids worked hard all year. You know, regardless of the wins and losses, at the end of the day, they worked. You know, we were always there. We were always there. They worked. They believed every day.
Again, congrats, Coach. Just, Coach, a little bit real quickly, what was your game plan coming into the night?
We wanted to keep Bowie and Carmelo out of the lane. Major emphasis on closing out and keeping people in front and then closing out on shots. Major emphasis on taking care of the ball and rebounding the ball. Major emphasis. And for the most part, we did that. First quarter, I think they had 12 shots in the lane and probably scored on 8 of those. So then second quarter, they had 6 shots in the lane and scored on 3 of those. We still put, you know, Bowie on the free throw line. We still put him on the free throw line, but, you know, we bend, but we didn't break. You know, Quillis was huge for us on the boards. Matt Coons was huge for us on the boards. Bertrand was huge for us on the ball. And then, you know, those two seniors, along with Childry, you know, they did their job.
Was the game plan to go zone? Because you earlier alluded to the fact that they were scoring inside, which was something that we noticed. And we noticed that you kind of went into a zone to kind of quell their penetration. Was that the plan?
Yeah, I think the entire section knows that I'm a man-to-man guy, and a lot of teams prepare for me that way. With this group, it's a little bit unique. We have a lot of length. So we said, hey, we're going to come out in a little 1-3-1, and we're going to switch it up depending on possessions. And I think that was effective.
Finally, Coach, your team shared the ball very well tonight. Their assist was really high of sharing the ball and being patient inside. What are your thoughts on that?
Major emphasis over the past 4 days. Major emphasis. We said to these kids, listen, if the ball goes from left to right, right to left, you have many of scoring opportunities, the defense will break down. And that's been our Achilles heel all year long, that we wanted to just take it on the first drive. But over the past 4 days, they believed, they trusted what we had to say to them. We had some ball reversals, and we had big guys cutting to the lane and finishing.
Thank you, Coach.
Terry, here with Emojo 2 TV. You played great today. Dropped 10 points. Played aggressive. We liked your emphasis. You not connected the game early in the season. You played aggressive. You're making baskets around the rim. You bring a little bit of added toughness on the rebounding tip. And today you seem to do that again. What was your mindset coming to this game after losing to them by 19 points at home just a couple games ago?
It was coming mean business. Albany, I haven't made it out the first round since. Well, our coaches haven't made it out the first round since they've been here. So it's something to do for the coaches, and I just don't want my season cut short. This is my first year playing varsity basketball. I don't want my season cut short.
This is a big victory for you guys. What are you looking forward to going to your next matchup, which would probably be, in all likelihood, Bethlehem?
We definitely owe Bethlehem one, a big one. We're just going to go in there with the same attitude, play tough, rebound, box out, attack them. Don't give up nothing easy. We need everything. We on the floor every single possession. And you just want to go out there and win.
Good job.
Okay, we're here with Mahdi Gaddy, a senior. He's been in the program for Albany High for 4 years now, and it seems to be your first time getting out of the first round. So what is your thoughts about absorbing all this, you know, all this right now, taking it all in, you know, after, you know, being in the program for so long?
I mean, it feels good since being in the program for 4 years. Since my first year to now, I mean, for like the first 3 years, I've seen seniors, like, really put their heart onto this court and really fell. So coming in this game and winning, it felt great. I do it for them seniors that couldn't do it.
I like how you've been playing, man, especially this game, man. You cut down the turnovers. You were being aggressive. You weren't being selfish, hooking your teammates up. I think you found the recipe. So what do you think is going to be the game plan when you go meet possible Bethlehems for the second time in the year?
Same thing, really just keep sharing the ball, looking in the post. They look to try to trap our good ones, so we got them role players. I need to step up and do what they got to do. So that's what we look forward to doing, getting them role players in the game.
Okay. All right. Thanks a lot. Emojo 2 TV, we're here with the Flying Horses head coach, Rich Hurley. Coach, a tough one tonight. What's your thoughts about how everything ended?
It's tough to win a game when we shoot as poorly as we did tonight. I think we were 2 of 17 from 3. We were 6 of 16 from the foul line. it's tough because you're not coaching this team anymore, you know, and your seniors are gone, and this is my 13th year doing it. This is the first time I've ever lost in the first round of a sectional game, so I don't know how to feel right now. But you just feel bad for the seniors, obviously. We played them a week and a half ago, and we played really well down there, and I try to explain to the guys that, you know, they're going to come in here ready to play. And I thought in the first half they played much harder than we did. We were slow defensively. We were not where we needed to be. Second half we made the adjustment, but our shots didn't fall. And that's a tribute to Albany. They contested. They fought. It's tough because I know we're a better shooting team than that, but it just didn't happen tonight. And as you know, as a coach and a former player, that sometimes you have those nights.
That's right. Yeah. Now, do you think the way the injury, you think Bowie still suffer from that injury?
I mean, you know, his ankle has been bothering him, but, you know, excuses. You know how it is. Sectional time. He's a gamer. It just, as you said to me after, he just felt bad. He didn't feel like he played well tonight, but our whole team didn't play well tonight. And, again, that's a tribute. Albany High was fantastic. They changed their game plan a little bit from a week and a half ago. They went to the 1-3-1 zone. You know, kind of kept us out of the lane. That's where we like to be when keeps Ryan Carmelo out of the lane, and if he faces us, take tough shots. You know, so like I said, it's a learning experience. Some sophomores on my team will hopefully learn from this, and juniors, and I wish Albany nothing but the best. This is just the sad part is there's no practice tomorrow.
Coach, at one juncture during the game, you elected to kind of play the foul, yeah. You know what I mean, the fouling game there a little bit. Take me a little bit through that. Well, did you want to wait? I thought that you could have kind of waited, maybe got a trap. You only had two fouls.
We had two team fouls, and the one thing, you know, I didn't want to wait a little bit, and then you get narrow it down to under a minute, and now you're somewhat scrambling. We actually had a chance to cut it to three. I think I thought the strategy worked. You know, it was a 50-50 thing. We decided to get the guys in there and foul, and I think only wasted maybe 8-9 seconds total. And like I said, I thought we had a chance. I think Bowie missed the front end of a 1-1. I would have made it 46-43, if I'm not mistaken, because I remember making this comment. There was 43-7 left. I said, if he makes them both, we're going to play it straight. And try to get a stop. We get a stop. We're down 3 with 8 seconds left, and then we missed it, and then that kind of was the end of the game right there.
Yeah. Basically, yeah, you did kind of get what you wanted out of that game. So what did you tell the guys there in closing?
I just said, like I said to Kenneth, I said the sad part is I'm not coaching Ryan Carmelo, Ethan Evans, you know, Elijah Davis, and Brandon Holmes. I'm not going to coach those guys or this team again. You know, I gave all the praise to Albany. I thought they played harder than us for the first half, you know, at least. Right. And it was just a tough night. I mean, we missed layups, free throws. You know, it was at one point our only made three was the Bowie banker. And then Elijah made the one in the corner there. As you guys know, you both coach it, you both played it. It's hard to win when shots aren't going in, and then there's game pressure. So now you're in a sectional game. The game pressure kicks in. You're feeling it. Now you're squeezing it a little longer, or maybe you're hesitating a little bit. And as you guys know, if you're not ready to go and you're feeling confident, shots aren't going in anyway. So I guess we got to learn from it, you know. And I got to learn from it as a coach. You know how it is. We always try to get better at our craft. And it's been tough. I mean, for us, you know, we don't have any post presence. So we can't get an easy basket. It's, you know, as you know, it's hard to not to, everything's all in the perimeter. Has to be a drive, has to be a drive and kick. It's got to be in transition for us to score. And teams that have zoned us and made it a half court game all year long, we've struggled. Saratoga, Shen, Albany tonight, Schenectady up there. We lack that personnel to break down that type of offense. And I'm not complaining, because I've had all the size in the world here when I've been here. So, but as you know, it's tough when you have to constantly score from outside in, and it's just hard to win that way.
Coach, I'm going to go a little bit off the topic here a little bit and get back on in a second. But Elijah Davis, I know history of that kid, you know what I mean? And he had a long road, and I'm very proud of him to get to the position. Can you talk about him a little bit?
You know, we had a senior night for him, and here's a kid who was in Vanderheiden probably 5 years ago. And then at our alternative learning program, shows up here as a sophomore. And he plays JV in 2 years of varsity. And then, you know, last year he didn't play a lot. And he's very bright. He's got 21 credits. He's going to graduate. He's being recruited by a couple of Division III schools. And that's what coaching's all about, as you know. And he's tough. And he can, you know, give you a run for your money sometimes. But as you know, I said that in the locker room. I mean, who would have thought, not a lot of people in this district would have thought that he would be on this team and in this locker room, you know, when he started in this school district. So I can't be more proud of my man. They call him Blue Kid, and I just love Elijah, man. I'm going to miss him.
Yep. Last thing, Coach, who would you venture out to choose for the Section 2? I know it's wide open, Coach, but I want to put you under pressure right now.
I mean, I said it a couple of weeks ago. I think Colony has the best starting five. They have the best basketball players. They got size. They're well coached. Not a lot of depth, but I think those are the best five. You know, Shen can shoot it so well, so you know you have to guard them, all five of their guys. But if they're off a little bit, then they're beatable. Colony got a tough draw. I don't know who won the other game. They got a Shaker Green Tech winner, which wasn't very nice for the one seed. And then there's Bethlehem, who, you know, they are probably the toughest group of players. Now you're not the most talented team, but they played the best together. They've waited this time. A great article in the paper today, and I've known those kids for a long time. They work out with me. They come to my camp. Rikers and Flynn's and Thompson's and Murray's. Those guys have been in this gym for years. So I'm going to say Colony just because I think they're the best talented group and team. But, heck, man, I didn't even mention Saratoga. So, I mean, you know, all those guys. I'm going to go with Colony, but just because I think it's their time.
Thanks a lot, Coach. Appreciate your time, Coach.